Hi folks, Rich Nass here, Brand Director for Design News. So I spent last week at the Design West show out in San Jose, used to be called the Embedded Systems Conference. I've been attending the show for a long time, maybe 20 years, and one of the things that always strikes me when I'm at this event is that the people who attend not only this event, but others like it, also known as design news readers, are really the creators of technology. In other words, we create the things that let people live the way they do. We create the cars, the phones, the homes, and everything else that people touch every day. Without design engineers, we wouldn't have any of the cool products that we do today. Some people think that engineers are geeks, but I have more than enough data to prove that that's not true. According to Wikipedia, and of course we all know that if it's on Wikipedia, it has to be true, right? Anyway, according to Wikipedia, the word geek is a slang term for odd or non-mainstream people with different connotations ranging from a computer expert or enthusiast to a person heavily interested in a hobby. If the definition had stopped there, I'd be good with it. However, it continues with a general pejorative meaning of a particular or otherwise dislikable person, especially someone who is perceived to be overly intelligent. Sigh. I was fine right up until that last point, up until the last part. Yes, we may be overly intellectual, but we're not dislikable, are we? Well, I'll let you chime in on that one. So there are a few highlights at the show that I wanted to mention to you. First, I got a ride in Nuvation's electric car. It's this three-wheel car that sits just a couple inches off the ground. It does 0 to 60 in about 5 seconds and has a top speed of 160 miles an hour. Very cool. We were driving around the streets of San Jose, and just about every person that we passed made some sort of comment. Some of them I certainly can't repeat here. But anyway, I'd like to thank Microchip for making that one happen. Next, there were classes at the show that were teaching people how to program with various development platforms like Arduino, BeagleBone, and Raspberry Pi. I attended a bunch of those, and I learned a lot. And don't tell anybody, but I scored a Raspberry Pi at the show. I'd like to thank Element 14 for that one. That doesn't make me a geek, does it? And finally, the real highlight, I got to meet one of Hollywood's biggest stars, Mayim Bialik. Yep, that's right, Mayim Bialik. You know her, right? Amy Farrah Fowler. Very cool. Anyway, until next week, and remember, think before you call us geeks.